Good morning, students.
Here I am again with you with a new lesson, Gulliver Arrives in Lilliput. Now, you might have listened to the story. Yes, the story of the Lilliputs. So, let us see. This passage is an adaptation of an excerpt from the famous novel, Gulliver Travels, written nearly 300 years ago by Jonathan Swift. Travel books were popular at the time, and this incredible story describes the strange and fantastic travel of Numeal Gulliver to different land. So let us see the story. It was the youngest of five brothers and had to leave school at the age of 17 because my father could not afford to pay my school fees. It was decided that I should take up the life of a seaman, and so it was that I went abroad, the Antelope, which was sailing out of the South Sea. The ship set sail from Bristol in May 1700. During the beginning of the journey, we enjoyed good weather. But on our way to the East Indies, we were caught up in a great storm and choppy sea. Now, who is telling the story to us? Itself, a Gulliver is telling a story. So, he was the youngest among the five brothers. But he had to leave the school at the age of 17. Why? Because their father were not able to pay the school fees. So what it was decided that the Gulliver will take up the life of seaman. So where did he went? He went abroad. Abroad means foreign land. Okay? The Antelope, which was sailing out to the South Sea. So he set the ship to sail from Bristol in a May. When he started to sail? In a May in 1700. Now, during the beginning, the journey was quite exciting. They were all very enjoying the good weather. But suddenly on the way to the East Indies, what happened? They caught in a great storm and choppy sea. Choppy seas means, now when the weather changes, there was a huge of the waves. No? So you might have seen before some days that we have observed in Mumbai also, yes, due to a cyclone, the waves were so huge, yes. Manning the ship with the moving up and down as hard work. Manning the ship means what? That is operating. Now in a hard, the ship was quite rough, so the waves were quite huge, so it was very difficult to operate the ship, and the dozen of our men died either because of work overload or the poor ration that were dotted out to us. Now, they were not traveling for a short distance. They were traveling for the long distance. So, during that period of time, so many men has died due to a bad weather, due to a bad rations, the lack of food, okay, or other diseases. Blown out course by strong wind, we found ourselves somewhere not to Van Diemen Land. The next morning, lashed by heavy rain, Antelope struck rock and founder. Six of us crewmen managed to escape from the wreck in a lifeboat. So great was the force of gale and that the boat capsized. Capsized means what? It turned over. So somehow they had tried themselves to come out of those heavy waves and the boat was being capsized. That means the boat was being completely turned out. So somehow they have saved their life. Okay? I had no idea what has happened to the other five. But I managed to survive. As I floated on the water washed by wind and the sea, I felt sure that I was going to die. Up till now, somehow he has survived. But as he was floating on the waves with the help of the winds, and suddenly he felt that now is the time that he is going to die. My leg gave away under me, and my great surprise, I found I could stand up in the water. I walked on before I got to dry land, and then some more searching for a house or someone could help me. So what the Gulliver did, he was quite surprised that his legs were getting under it, and he found that he can stand up in the water. That means, where was he now? He was near the seashore. Somehow he was trying to find the dry land and some people, houses, who can offer him a medicine, food, yes, so that he can be survived, can help him. But suddenly I was completely exhausted. Exhausted means one student? Tired. I collapsed. Means I fell. Who fell down? The Gulliver fell down on the short soft of grass and fell into a deep sleep. It was a daylight when I woke up and found I could not move. Lying on my back, I discovered that my arms and legs were tied down to the ground with a string. Now the Gulliver was completely tired because he has come to a long way. Yes, he has to swim. And when he got up, it was almost a day. And what he found that? He was tied with a rope. Yes, you can see in a picture. My longer ear was held down in the same way, and thousands of strings across my body had held me to the ground. I could not move. Even his longer hair was tied up. See, you can see here. Yes, all the armies with a bow and arrow, and the man has tied them with the string. In a picture you can see. All I could do, lying on my back and look up to the sky. Then warm, bright sunlight began to hurt my eyes. At the same time, I could hear the noise around me. Soon I felt something climbed onto my foot and start moving up my body. It came near my face. So suddenly at what happened? The sun was rising. Yes? When the sun came into our middle, what happened? The light of the sun start hurting to the Gulliver's eye. And what he found out is someone was climbing on his body. And that person came very near towards his face. Turning my eyes downward as far as I could see, I was amazed to see a teeny little man. He was not more than 6 inches tall and appeared to be dressed as a soldier. So turning his eyes towards to the downwards. And what he saw? A man. And what was the height of the man? Only a 6 inches. And what type of a cloth the man was wearing? A cloth of a soldier. Then another 40 men like him climbed on to me and looked into my face. Surprise! I gave out a great scream. The little man then ran off in fright, and as they jumped off my body, some of them were injured. Then one of the little men, braver than the rest, climbed back onto my body and looking into my face, he threw up his arm and in a clear voice shouted something. Others took up his cry, but of course I could not understand what they meant. So it was quite a surprise for both of them. Yes, for the Gulliver also and for those people also. Now what the Gulliver did, he screamed loudly. And as he screamed loudly, what happened? The soldiers, they fell down from his body. They started jumping down. And with that incident, what happened? The Gulliver got hurt. Yes, some of the scratches has been developed in his body. And even he can hear the voice that they were shouting. After straining very hard, I managed to tear open the string and free one arm. I also managed to raise my head, which gave me great pain as many as my hair were torn off. So after a very hard, so what the Gulliver had did, somehow he has he has managed to tear up the string and to free one arm, and somehow he has managed to raise his head, okay, because his head were also been tied up with a string. So the Gulliver felt a lots of pain because due to a pulling, what happened, the some of his hair were torn off. What he did next, he reached to catch some of the little man, but they were too quick for me. Okay, they were too quick for Gulliver. Why? Because they were very small. They can run off easily. Okay. Then what the Gulliver felt? The Gulliver felt that there was a thousand of needles were pricking in his hand, and discovered that the little man were shooting arrows at him. Now the arrow were no longer than the size of the pin. So what was the size of the pin? Very small. Use a safety pin? Yes. The safety pins are quite small. So the size of the arrows were compared to the pin. But when it enters into a Gulliver's face, what happened was quite painful. Okay? Fearing that some of the arrows may penetrate in his eyes, what he did, he put a hand across his face to protect them. Then what he decided that he have to use the wisest plan, that would to lie quiet till a night without any movement. What he will do, he will stay still, he will stay asleep, okay, stay still till a night. Then he could easily and quickly free himself. But there was a fear of this little pupil. If they were no larger than what he had already seen. But it was not to be. When the little man saw that he calmed down. When they saw that Gulliver had come down, they stopped shooting at him. However, that has increased the clamor, the noise. Okay? He realized that the number had become a greater. Now, previously there were only a handful of pupils. But now what happened? There were lots of people that were surrounded towards the Gulliver. Now the sound was been heard by his ears. What he did, he turned off his head and saw that some of the little men were escaping a platform. That means they were creating a ladder, a platform, okay, about 18 inch high. When the platform was completed, the four little men got up on it. One of them, who appeared to be older and somewhat higher than the other three, wore a beautiful clock which were held up to the ground by a teeny little boy standing behind him. So when the 18-inch platform was being covered, what he saw? The three men has climbed over the platform, and one of them was an older, and other were wearing different types of clothes that were different from the people that were surrounded him. The man in the cloak said something in a clear, okay? The man was wearing a lobby like a king, you can say, or robe like a king. Was something was telling, it was loud voice, okay? Immediately a large group of little folk means people, came near to the Gulliver, that is near to the head, and cut the remaining string that held my head down, that held the Gulliver's head down. He could now see the pupil on the platform clearly. The man in the clock must have been said to their leader, made a long speech, and although he could not understand what he has said. Now the Gulliver, what the man in a clock has given, he has given a long speech to the pupils, those who were gathered around him. But Gulliver was unable to understand what he said. He managed to follow what he was saying as he waved his arm about in a sort of sign of language. He presumed that he was telling me that he would not harm if he did as he was told. So he was using a different type of a sign of a language. And what message he wants to derive? He wants to derive the message that they are not going to give, they are not going to harm the Gulliver if he do what they want him to do. But what they said, if Gulliver tried to break or free himself, then what they will do? They will kill him. I guessed that I understood what he meant and remained quiet. But then he realized he had nothing to eat for a great many hours and put his hand to my mouth, to his mouth, to show he wanted to eat. Then the Gulliver realized that there were so many of hours he has not eaten. Okay, so what he did, he put his hand to his mouth. What he wants to show? That he was hungry and he needed something to eat. The leader seems to understand what he wanted. Okay, and then turned to the little folk and gave an order. What order he gave them? That to bring up food for the Gulliver. Almost immediately 100 men marched up to his face carrying a food, okay, which has been sent to him by their king as soon as he had heard of his arrival. I did not know what the food was. Okay, the Gulliver did not know what the food was. Hence, the size of beans, loaves of bread, which he ate two or three at a time because they were quite smaller in size according to the size of the human being. The weak folks, that means the very snail or the teeny folk or the teeny pupil, emitted a cry of surprise that he could eat so much so quickly. Then he indicated that he wanted to drink something. So after eating the food, what he did? He indicated that he needed water to drink. A large number of men carried a great pot of milk and poured it into his mouth. He asked for another pot of milk and they brought it. But when he called up the third, they made a sign there was no more. So when he again asked twice a time, the people had presented the Gulliver a pot of milk. But when he asked for a third one, what they show? They showed that there was no, they showed it in a sign there was a no pot of milk. He had drunk all the milk in the country. After this generous milk, sleep descended upon him. That's why his father day in, that was his first day, you can say, in Lilliput. So you might have understood the story, children, that how the Gulliver has came into a Lilliput world. So let us see the grammar now. Today I am going to explain you the present particles. A particle is a verb form that has a special rule for uses in a sentence. There are two types of particle, present particles and past particles. Okay? A present particle is a verb form that end with ing, sail plus ing, sailing, lie plus ing, lying, shine plus ing, shining. Present particles can be used as verb, but they are not complete verb when used by themselves. You cannot use a present particle as the only verb in a sentence. You need to add a helping verb to it. For example, the sun shining, so Gulliver woke up. The sun was shining, so Gulliver woke up. So this is the wrong sentence. So what you are using here? Was. Okay? Here you add the helping verb was, a form of the verb be. Present particles are often used as an adjective. Sleeping man, sailing ship, shining sun. Now students, I will explain you the past particles. The past particles is a verb form that usually end with ed or d. Float plus ed, floated. Collapse plus d. So only d has been added, collapsed. The past particle of some verb called irregular verbs do not follow the usual pattern that most verbs do. choose, chosen, fall, fallen, write, written, sing, sung, fly, flown, freeze, frozen. Past particle can be used as verb, but they are not complete verb when used by themselves. Gulliver eaten nothing and was hungry. Gulliver had. Here I have used had. Had eaten nothing and was hungry. Here you added the helping verb had, a form of the verb have. Past particles are often used an adjective. Wash clothes, tired sailor, fallen tree, broken lamb. Okay, now here you have to complete the sentence with the present or the past particles. The boy had been waiting for a long time for the bus. I like to go for a walk when I am bored. I like Rohan, but he can be very annoying at times. I thought the paper was very confusing. The book have already been covered. They made sure that the food was not wasted. That was an interesting story. I told her a joke and she was very amused. The boy fixed the broken car. All of them are working women. Using of words. Okay, manning the ship with it moving up and down was hard work. The highlighted phrase is an example of binomial. In a binomial, two words are joined by a conjunction. Note that the order of the word is fixed. We cannot say down and up. Only we can say up and down. Okay, so in here we have to use some binomials. Seats covered on the bus take a lot of wear and tear. This morning meeting was short and sweet. Has he been sick? He just skin and bones. We love the hustle and bustle of the marketplace. The child swayed back and forth to the music. A suffix is a letter or a group of letters added to the end of a word to make a new word. Post plus age, postage. King plus dome, kingdom. Friend plus ship, friendship. Kind plus ness, kindness. Enjoy plus meant, enjoyment. Joy plus full, joyful. Okay, now we will add here some suffix. A lot of gentleness is needed to look after a baby. We felt that the penalty given was to serve a punishment for such a petty crime. The two children played on the beach under the watchful eye of their father. I went to sleep during the speech out of sheer boredom. A large percentage of students play some sport or the other. Some parents go through a lot of hardship in order to educate their children. Okay, now here the spelling students, we have to use BL, CL and FL. I am a wooden toy that you can stop block. So what I have used? BL. I am very small jumping insect. Flea, FLEA. I am a piece of cloth attached to a pole usually representing a country. Flag, FLAG. I am a hint to help you solve a mystery. Clue, CLUE. I am a fat, round drop, usually of something sticky or thicky, bulb, B-L-O-B. I am a loose outer piece of clothing without sleeves, cloak, C-L-O-K. So student, you might have understood the lesson very well and also the grammar part. So we will see you on the next session. Have a good day.